All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the PlayOn Sports and CIFNorthCoast.tv post-game show here. I am with, we have two stars tonight. They're both sophomores. Stellar sophomores is what we're going with. And my first one is none other than Paris Austin. Paris, pleasure to get to have you up here as an interview subject. Now, I mean, much was made about Ivan Rabb, the guy I'm going to be getting to after you, but I didn't hear not a single bo peep about you until tonight. Is that the way you like it? Do you like kind of flying under the radar and then kind of showing up?
Yeah, because like usually a lot of people is worrying about Ivan. So like when they double team at Ivan, I usually get my points off like that. But yeah, I like being under the radar because usually a lot of people don't know who I am. Therefore, I can make a name for myself.
And you were doing it in all capacities tonight. You had a team-high 27. Actually, that led all scorers out there on the floor tonight. And you did it in a variety of ways. You hit a couple threes. I felt that your jumpers were on. And then you were pretty and gliding to the lane. Your free throws, it seemed like you didn't miss a beat there. Just a great all-around game. What do you feel is your biggest strength? And I guess what do you feel is your biggest weakness that you might have to work on moving into now the NorCal regional state picture?
As of offense, my biggest will probably be shooting. I like to shoot it a lot. I work on my jumper a lot at school, but I like to think that I'm a good defender. And sometimes I lack at, like, kind of cutting to the basket when Ivan got the ball sometimes, because usually I sit out on the three-point a lot, but I need to work on cutting to the basket and moving without the ball.
Yeah, you said you like defense, and I thought that was another reason why we were so impressed with you. You were active. Hands were active. You were always looking for the steal in any which way. A couple steals you did get, and they did result in some fast break points. Your team is just clicking right now at the right time. You guys have won 19 in a row now, 20 in a row with this win. You guys haven't lost to a Northern California team. How are you guys doing it?
Just coming out there playing basketball every day. We work hard in practice, and it's paying off.
And how happy is it to wear one of these golden medals around your neck?
It feels real good. Last year, I was supposed to get one because I had just moved up to varsity last year.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't get to get one, and it felt good to get one this year.
Awesome. And should we expect more?
Yes,
more kind of coming out parties like this in the NorCal regional?
Yes.
Yes?
We're trying to get the state and win it.
Okay. Thank you so much for joining us. And now it's time for part two of our interview. So now we'll get Ivan Rabb. Once again, folks, that was Paris Austin. 27 points tonight. Phenomenal. Really scored in every variety. And now the big man himself. The man, they say, has a Cookie Monster-like approach for rebounds. Cookie Monster hunger. I was calling him the Big Bad Rabb. Is that one cool? You like that one?
Yeah, it's nice.
Or we could go with the Mean, Lean, Rebounding Machine. However you want to put it, this guy is a beast. He's a double-double waiting to happen every night. I'm talking about Ivan Rabb, again, another sophomore, very talented sophomore. It's crazy to just think that you and Paris are sophomores playing the way you did tonight. And I was telling Paris, if you guys can somehow continue to pick each other's brains and become best friends and really develop this brother-like chemistry in the next 2 years, it's amazing to see what's going to come with you guys in your senior year. Do you feel the same way?
Yeah, we are best friends. We've been playing together since the fourth grade, and we know our each other's hot spots. We know where to find each other, and we're just going to continue to get better and continue to stay a family. We're real close.
Yeah, because you know that no big man is successful without a point guard to back him up, and it seems like you guys play that big man point guard role just like maybe Kobe and Shaq did when they were with the Lakers. Now, I mean, you know, you've been noted as saying you like the attention, and you felt that you weren't having fun last year, and I was reading this article here about you, Dragon Force, and I'm just thinking, I mean, you guys won North Coast section last year. You won state. How weren't you having fun?
Well, I was having fun, but at the same time, I was just waiting on my moment to go in and play. I love seeing my teammates do well. I love seeing everybody do well. I'm glad we won a lot of games, but I just wanted to play a little bit more, which I'm not trying to be selfish or anything, but that's what I had in my head mentally.
And have you still kept in good conversation with Longroos or Ashley or any of the guys that have kind of been stars of late that are playing prominent roles in college right now?
A lot of the seniors come to our games. Only one I believe hasn't been to our game is Junior.
Okay.
But everybody else has been coming to
visit. Have you seen Jordan Barton?
He wasn't on my team.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
right,
I think
right.
I believe that was the year before.
You were a freshman last
year.
What was it like to make it to state last year and Was it so good that you guys have that hunger to want to be there again this year?
Oh, yeah. It was a good experience because everybody says AAU basketball is different from high school, and it definitely was because every game was tougher and tougher. We never played a weak opponent. We always had every game there was somebody, one or two or three, maybe five people on the team that was really good. So we always had to key in on those players and take them out and play well, execute on offense and defense.
Now let's do a little forecasting here. Let's just say, I know you can only take it one game at a time, but let's just say you do go into the open division, which you guys are more than likely going to do, and you do knock off the top teams that are ahead of you, and you have a date with a team that you've already played this year, depending on if they advance through the open division. I'm talking about modern day. You guys lost to them earlier this year. They're the number two team in the nation. Was there anything that you took away from that loss that you guys feel like you guys have worked on, and if you do see them again, you're ready for them?
Well, I think if we do so happen to play modern day again in the championship, I think we'll be a little bit better than last time. They have a lot of players. We have a lot of players. We just have to come ready, and we all just have to have our best game.
Okay.
As well as him.
And last question, how's it feel to have another one of these?
Feels great. Feels great.
All right, folks, that's Ivan Rabb. Once again, another stellar sophomore. They have two guys that, I'm telling you, I told Paris this, and Rabb already knows the deal. These guys continue to keep progressing and playing the way they did tonight. Man, they can go to any college they so choose to play basketball, and that's going to be a lovely thing. Well, guys,
all right.
Thank you so much for joining us.
No problem.
I know you have a lot of celebrating to do with your friends and family, but not too much because you guys are going to be getting back right back at it.
Next week.
Practicing it next week for the States and NorCal Regionals. So enjoy it tonight and then practice hard, and we can't wait to see you in the playoffs.
All right. Thank you.
All right, guys. Once again, give it up for Ivan Rabb and Paris Austin. Look, he's going to sneak in the shot a little bit. There we go. They are our stellar sophomores and our co-players of the game. Here on the PlayOnSports.com post-game show. We'll be right back, Steven and I, to wrap things up here from Dublin High School.